caffeine level almost, right? So I know we're here to listen to Bart. He's going to talk about the cars and to drive first and foremost, but I want to frame a little bit on how we're doing. It's been an extraordinary year for us. And obviously, it's been a year about a move to Atlanta. We stepped up to a pretty extraordinary challenge as a company to relocate from our home in Montvale, New Jersey, lose 60% of our people, hire 250-plus people in Atlanta. And what started really as a relocation for us has really become a company transformation. So the mantra that we're using inside of our building is MBUSA 2.0. Let us not lose this opportunity that as we move and as we bring in new energy from all these new people, all this great talent that we found in Atlanta, let's use this as a big transformation opportunity because we really do believe that this sets us up for the next 50 years, certainly from a cost structure, from a talent structure. We weed through legacy issues that we've been dealing with in a facility that you've been in for 50 plus years. This just gives us an opportunity to start fresh, and we're doing that. And we obviously wanted to come into the community and make a little bit of a statement. I think the Mercedes-Benz Stadium deal was a way for us to say, hey, we're here to stay, this is gonna be our home, and we don't wanna be out in the corporate park, out in the suburbs, but we wanna be a vital member of that community. So we're off to a great start. But let's talk about our business because it's a great year. We're on another record-setting pace, but a record-setting pace that's got some challenges associated with it. So we're up a little over 7%, which is great. And the market is again, back to 2006 levels, above 17 million, 17.1, 17.2 million this year. But all of the growth, interestingly enough, every bit of the growth in both the mass market and the luxury market has been driven by trucks. So passenger cars are essentially flat to slightly decreasing, and all the market growth is coming from trucks. So while we say that this is a SUV feeding frenzy, we said that at the beginning of the year, and it's actually more than true. So for the companies that have had the advantage of product availability and new product offering, those have been taking disproportionate advantage of what the market is offering. One of our biggest challenges for the year is the success track that Mercedes-Benz is on globally. We're up as a company 15% around the globe. What's happened over the last several years is that when other markets in Europe were sputtering, we were always able to get that incremental volume and get it for the United States. This is a year where we frankly weren't able to get that. So there have been some limiting factors in our ability to grow as fast as we like. We're growing pretty much exactly on pace with the luxury market, but when you're in the middle of the biggest product offensive in the company's history, just growing at the same rate as the market is not that satisfying. But we can't do anything about a GLC. The GLK runout is happening this year. It's about to be replaced by the GLC. So the table is set for what will be for us an even better 2016. Actually, 2016 will be our biggest of the product offensive years, that 7-year period where we're launching one car after another. 2016 is our biggest launch here, so we're really excited about that. But we're here to talk about AMG. We're growing close to 30%. I think it's 28.7% AMG growth. So great trajectory there. And we're really reaching a point in our AMG trajectory where we have to take a different approach, a more fundamental, what I call shop-in-shop approach to the AMG brand. As we expand models like the GT, and we've got more products coming in the future, when we add the sport models, we're suddenly expanding our lineup, but we can't treat it exactly like we've been treating it. And a lot of our dealers treat AMG like it's the most expensive Mercedes-Benz. We need to, the mentality I'm trying to get from our dealers is to say, you need to treat AMG as if it were a Porsche franchise that sits inside of your Mercedes-Benz store. That's the mentality that we're going for, and we're asking for some pretty significant investments. We're going to create AMG performance centers around the country, around 100 of them. We don't want everybody to be a performance center, but there's three kind of main components. We're going to have an extra incentive attached to those dealers that want to come along on this journey and professionalize their approach to that. So we're going to give them extra earning opportunity on some of their highest earning models, and that's what AMG represents. We're going to ask them to step up and make a more significant shop-in-shop investment. The cornerstone of that investment is what we call the AMG Powerwall, and it's a big 8x8 high-tech, high-def surround sound kind of a system that will allow our AMG sales professionals to really articulate what the AMG difference is. So we're gonna let the customer go under the skin, and we're gonna pull apart the vehicle and the engine, and we're gonna give them sort of the kind of selling points that you need to articulate why is it worth that extra $15,000 or $20,000 premium over the corresponding Mercedes-Benz. So we're starting it this year. We're gonna have 10 of these AMG Performance Centers finished by Christmas, and then the full rollout period will be 2016. So as we are rolling out great models, sport models, the GT, and there's gonna be more, the GTS, then comes the GT, and more after that, we need to really step up our game in how we treat the AMG customer and how we treat the AMG brand. So exciting times for AMG, exciting times for Mercedes-Benz.